that. Running off the block, yeah, I'm something like a linebacker. I got juice like a Fanta. How you like it?
How you like it?
I'm on purple, I'm on yellow, like a Viking.
Like a Viking.
All these plays that I'm catching, I done gone crazy. I do my thing, six range, just like Tom Brady. Touchdown, I just scored a whole bucket. I just dropped the bag on the tag, ain't nothing. Make them throw a flag when I pass, come through stunning. Call me Ty Gurley, hit the hole, then I ran it. Get money, you ain't trying to get that second flag on the play. Hating from the sideline, a flag on the play. Like Julio with them Falcons, I just made a play. In the red zone, going strong, watch me shake and bake. I'm in the field like a Panther, I done up the standards. Like Michael Vick in Atlanta when it's time to scramble. Neck full of water.
We are about 40 miles or so south of Candlestick Point at a place that first opened back in 2014. As you get a look at Levi's Stadium here in Santa Clara, California. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Los Angeles Rams and the San Francisco 49ers. The shadow's starting to get a bit longer. Week 10 of the NFL season is here, and we're underway on EA Sports. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line.
At their own 23-yard line.
Carry of the game for Cam Akers. And not much there. Maybe a yard up to the 24.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. On the counter, this is Akers. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Down.
A tough spot here on their opening drive. This is third and seven. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Byron Murphy. And they will be set up now as he brings this thing all the way back inside the 20. So far this season, this defense has had their issues against the pass, so that's a great sign for them to get the early pick.
Yeah, confidence builder for them and an absolute shock for the quarterback because he went into it. He saw the numbers we saw. He watched them on tape. I think he came into this one thinking this is going to be a big day, and it very well could be. But early in this one, advantage defense.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. Escaping the pressure right. And this is intercepted, but they'll say out of bounds. So very close to a turnover there in the end zone. The target that time, Michael Thomas. And now it's second down. This is going to be intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So a pretty shaky start here for both sides.
Yeah, each quarterback's throwing a ball to the other team. Do you think on both sidelines they're sitting them down and saying, okay, remember, This is the color jersey we're wearing. They're wearing the other color. Let's make sure we get it to our guys, please.
A really nice gain of 25 yards. Well, maybe that'll help him settle back into a groove after the interception on the first drive here, picking up the first to start drive number two.
And it is just starting over, isn't it? Sometimes it's just how you have to do it. You have to erase things from your mind. Don't worry about what happened before, because over the course of a game, the good players, things turn out pretty well for them, and that's what he's trying to do here.
A huge play that time for the Rams. 42 yards. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. That's caught. It's Thomas. And the Rams are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. Add this game to the last one, and they move the ball over 50 yards in two plays. They'll look to throw again. And this is caught. He's got it. Touchdown, L.A. Cam Akers, his second touchdown on the season. And the Rams are going to take a first quarter lead. Picking up where they left off before the open week that they had last week, as they won going into that, and no signs of being stale.
No, and that's really big for them, because there's a trust factor that goes into this, because what often happens, if you win the game before your open week, you should get more time off. But if you win the game before the open week, get more time off, and don't play well the next time out, that goes away. So they're making a statement that they like that time off.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away.
The Niners take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told them, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
Now a nice play defensively on first down as this is knocked away and incomplete. DeMarcus Robinson, the intended target on that one. And that'll bring up second down. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. He's got this one complete to Perriman. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
They'll look to throw for it on third and one. Buying time to his left. When in doubt, do it yourself as he keeps it for 3 and a 1st down.
When they watch film of this game and hand out the grade sheets, he's going to really like getting a double plus on this play. Why? He scrambles and picks up a 1st down. But what else does he do? Protects himself by sliding and avoiding the big hit. Double plus, big time play.
So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. Nothing on that one. It'll be 2nd down.
That was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained. So they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's 2nd and 10. First carry for Josh Jacobs. And he's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of four.
The ball carrier.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive. And once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Looking for Perriman there. He's got him. And he is going to have a 49ers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
10 at the 28-yard line.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Rams 7, 49ers nothing.
First down, he'll drop to throw it. Got an open man, the tight end, Jarwin. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. Blake Jarwin, his second touchdown on the season. And the 49ers are within an extra point of tying this thing up. Kaimi Fairbairn on for the extra point. It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2.
Seven. Mitch Wishnowsky to kick off for San Francisco.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. On the return, here's a speedy Jamison Crowder. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line.
25-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
It's second and inches at the 35-yard line.
Still a few inches short of a first down as they come up now on second down. They'll toss this right side to Cam Akers. He's got a first down and then some at midfield. And finally, down at the 36-yard line. That one covers 29 yards. First down.
You know, I have a pretty good friend, Charles Davis, who tells me that when he sees plays like that, strong runs to the right, reminds him of the 1960s Green Bay Packers.
Boy, those were the days back when the fullback actually carried the ball as well as blocked. Then you had a halfback. Yeah, pulling guards, guys who could get out and run. And you can hear the great coach saying it back then. So we get a seal here and a seal here, and we run this play right in the alley.
Now this throw caught left side and inside the 20 before he's brought down. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. Catch number 100 for his career right there, and it's good enough to keep the chains moving. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. Looking left side. It's complete. He's got it. And the Rams are going to have a first and goal as he's taken down at about the 8-yard line. 11 more on that one and another first down.
8-yard line.
He'll throw complete to Cam Akers. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
The line of scrimmage, the 7 now on second and goal. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. That's complete right around the 8. And he'll get nothing out of that one. No yardage to speak of whatsoever. Leads to a third down.
Usually the offense has an answer to anything a defense throws at them, including a safety valve. And that's what they did on that play. They went there, but the defense still made an excellent play and held them to no gain.
Well, the ball mere inches from the white line on third and goal. And down he goes. Pressure gets him back at the 14.
Third and goal, they decided to throw for it, but how about the play defensively? Couldn't find anyone open, left him nowhere to go with the football, had to absorb the sack.
Now Jake Elliott for the field goal try. The kick by Elliott is good. And the Rams have the first points here. It's 3-0. So the drive stalls out inside the 15-yard line, but they do get three.
And I've talked with enough players nowadays that when they have these types of kicks, that no one says to their guy, hey, that's just like making an extra point, piece of cake. Because the extra point is not a piece of cake anymore. But kicking a field goal from that distance, just give him confidence and let him knock it through.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, you've almost got to get down to those starters blocks like you're a sprinter. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the passer.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they've got to try something because right now they're just cutting them to shreds.
First play, the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And now the Rams have got it going the other way. And they are going to take possession of the football inside the 15 at the 14-yard line. Game clock at 2:01. Time for one final play before the two-minute warning. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. A minute 55 left to go in the first half of play. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth,
yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy.
From the 2 now, second and goal. And it's complete. He's got it in the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Ian Thomas, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Rams tack on to their advantage. It's good to make it 17-7.
Makes the score Rams 17, 49ers 7. Jake Elliott set to kick off.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And this will make it into the end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of 1 there. 6-yard line. San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions, but some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, punt the ball away, get yourself set to play defense, but when you turn it over, it changes momentum, and when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8.
this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves them staring up here at a third and eight. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Eluding the pressure right. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete. So after three drives and three touchdowns combined between these two clubs, finally we get a defensive stop.
Yes, and welcome to the party, defensive players, and glad to have you, because for a while there, it almost felt like it was 11 going downfield on air. Okay, so to be able to have someone come up, make a stop, now we got a football game going.
So on fourth down, here's the Australian native Mitch Wishnowsky to punt this one away. Back deep, the former All-Pro Tyler Lockett. Now it's Lockett. And that'll be a return of 12 following a very nice punt. And the Rams will go on offense here with a first and 10.
28-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that can change things.
Looking for Lockett, and it's intercepted. It's the former Seahawk, Richard Sherman. And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line. A young quarterback, Charles, rolling to his right. I know it's right-handed, but is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember with young quarterbacks, it may take a few years before they get all the stuff out of them that they did earlier in their career or even in their college days when they were used to being dominant. In this case, the NFL veteran defense ended up winning the battle.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Throw left side, complete. That's Jacobs. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half. So they had the big loss on that first down pass play and facing a second and long. They will run the draw with Jacobs and dropped at the 35, but able to display some strength on the run. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. So third down now. They need the 27-yard line for a first.
Mike 51.
Here we go.
Flushed out right. He may try and run for this. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets it down to the 30 there. 5 yards that time out of the scramble. But now they're looking at a fourth down situation.
Well, partner, nothing comes open here, so he decides to escape out of there. And he doesn't pick up a first down, but he does gain additional yardage to set up a possible field goal attempt if they decide to go that route.
And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. And they're back within a touchdown. It's 17-10. So the 3 points here, they're still down, but they put somewhat of a dent into that lead going into the break.
Anything helps when you're trying to chip away at a lead, but they do know that they're going to need a little bit better effort in the second half.
Mitch Wishnowsky to kick off for San Francisco.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Now it's Crowder. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30.
The Rams take over first and 10 at their own 31-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
It leads to second and 10.
Scrimmage, the 31, as they line up second and 10. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. Here's Jake Elliott. Career long, by the way, for him, 61 yards. This will be spotted just shy of midfield, a 59-yard attempt. And this kick is not going to be close. It's well short, well right to boot. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we'll send you eastward to Orlando, standing by with that EA Sports Halftime Report now is Jonathan Coachman. Take it away, Coach. The 49ers going to have the football and trailing on the scoreboard as we get back underway on EA Sports. This taken in about 4 yards deep, and he will not bring it out. It's a touchback. Set to get this drive underway. And last time, able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just, I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for 6. Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a 2nd and 5. They'll stay on the ground with Jacobs. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 12 yards there and a first down.
First and 10 at the 42-yard line.
They will run out of the gun with Jacobs. And 3 yards there takes him to the 45.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
On 2nd down, here's the option. And that's thrown to Perriman out wide. That one good for the completion percentage, but no gain. It'll be 3rd down.
And that's when it's fun to play defense. When you're able to diagnose a play right from the beginning, get all your guys to the football, and spill the play, that's when you have a lot of fun playing on that side of the ball.
Drop to throw. This one complete to Jordan Reed. And he gets it just shy of midfield, but that's not enough. He's short of the marker. They get only 4 that time as that leads us to a 4th down. The offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on fourth and three. They're going to try and throw. That's caught out left by Perriman. And he gets this one across midfield for the first down of the 46. But we kind of looked at each other as they decided to go for it. But in the end, great execution, a 6-yard gain, and it all works out. They'll look to throw here on first down. Flush to his right. And he's going to lose a yard or two, taken down behind the line.
You know, on these types of plays, we're always looking to assess blame. Okay, where did it break down? Sometimes it's just a great play.
Rams 46-yard line.
The sack cost him only a yard. It's second and 11. Now it's third and five.
That's a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on it before he could get much out of it.
And on third and five, this will be the eighth play of the drive. Looking to throw. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And they went the wrong way there, losing yardage. Back at the 43-yard line.
It's fourth.
Boy, how good has this defense been seemingly all game long?
I really think right from the first snap, I think you're really onto something there. In this passing game, it just can't get off the ground. And that play, it wound up losing yardage.
He'll look to throw. And he's going to go down. Across midfield, he sacked at the 46. The Niners go for it, but it doesn't work out. And it'll be a turnover on downs. They'll come out throwing here on first down. They'll set up the screen here to Akers. The 20! And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain.
That's why you call a screen. You want to catch a defense overcommitting. Plenty of space available, and that matched up perfectly. What a convoy he got downfield to pick up big yardage on that play.
He takes us down to about the 12 for a gain of three.
The tackle made at the 12-yard line. A 3-yard pickup. Brings up second and seven.
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Here's a second and seven. Got an open man. It's Radley. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. The Rams, they are on the move. They've got another first down.
Another nice pickup through the air. And I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon. But with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
They'll look to run with Akers. And no signal yet. I don't think he got in. He didn't. They'll mark him at the one.
Short of the goal line.
No gain on the play, and it's going to be second and goal.
Second and goal.
Another shot from the one on second and goal. Again, it'll be Akers. And that play's not going to get him in as he stopped right at about the line of scrimmage. They hold him again, and now all of a sudden it's third and goal at the one. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal.
to throw. And this is caught. He's got it. Touchdown, L.A. From a yard out. And the Rams add on to their lead. Well, it was third and one. I was expecting runs, so much for that. They pass it. They score it.
That had the feel of the head coach telling the offensive coordinator, you've got four downs here. We're going to go for it on fourth down unless there's a disaster on third. Go ahead and take a shot if you want to. And he gratefully accepted the opportunity and did exactly that. If they didn't get it there, that had the feel that they would come back and try it on fourth down.
At their own 25-yard line.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave them great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do and the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
Trying to lay one up deep. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
We've seen that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
They'll go to the air here on third and two. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he is going to have a Niners first down, and he's going to have it by plenty, able to get 8 yards there on third and two. To throw now on first down. A look over the middle, and he's got Perriman. That one good for 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short.
It's second and inches at the 50-yard line.
Now here's a throw that's complete. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
First and 10 at the 45-yard line.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. He's got this one complete to Perriman. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two.
8 yards on the pick.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's 49er football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble.
We just saw another example of really good defensive football, which has led to the cushion that they have in this game. Got to him once again, knocked him on the ground, forced an incompletion.
Yeah, they've set the tone. It's one thing to set the tone, another to come in here on the road and set the tone. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he is going to have a 49ers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. They'll get a dozen there, and it's a first down, 49ers.
First and 10 at the 25-yard line.
And he's out of bounds, almost gets to the 10. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
You know, as a defensive guy, I don't normally do this, Brandon, but a tip of the cap to the offensive coordinator. Design quarterback run at this stage of the fourth quarter when I expected him to throw the ball, and he got a first down.
Yeah, trailing this stage of the fourth quarter, picked up the first, stopped the clock too.
Yeah, sometimes there's some guts in play calling when you go against the grain because you know you could easily be criticized if it doesn't work out.
That's complete right around the 8. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
Second and 5 at the 8-yard line.
To the goal line, but it's incomplete. He couldn't get the hook up there that time with Thomas. Third down here.
Down near the goal line, things really get physical. You're always anticipating a running play, but when they do throw it, things happen quickly. A little bit of a bang-bang play there that falls incomplete.
They come up now, 3rd and 5, following the incomplete pass. Here's Jacobs from the gun. And he takes this one into the end zone. And all of a sudden, here in the final minute, things get a little bit tighter.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively there, you're probably hoping for a 1-5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right. And if you have that 1-5 play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way downfield, they got the touchdown, but it's almost like, yeah, you know.
Doesn't feel right.
Exactly.
Now it's Crowder. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line.
The Rams take over 1st and 10 at their own 21-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And this game not quite in hand yet. We'll likely see all 3 timeouts defensively and then reassess where we are. And that's just a solid, good physical run there as he motors for 9 yards.
At the 30-yard line.
Didn't get to the sticks, but that's an ideal carry there on 1st down, isn't it?
I mean, now you're 2nd and 1. Although, you know, in the NFL, even if he picked up the 1st down, I don't think it's a big difference because the clock doesn't stop.
Yeah, not like college.
Right. If it's college football, you want to 2nd and 1 is probably better than picking up the 1st down because in college football, the clock stops with every 1st down and actually aids the defense in that situation.
From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. Now a toss play for Akers. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. Now the Niners going to signal for their 3rd and final timeout as the clock will stop with 35 seconds left to go. Here's a run with Akers on 2nd down. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. 1 yard is the loss. They back up even further to a 3rd and 15. On 3rd down, here's a run by Akers. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. I know there may be temptation to go for it here in overtime, but you have to punt the football.